How does AMD's Ryzen 3 1200 compare with Intel's G4560 once it's overclocked? Howdy howdy guys, Ponchato here, and today we're going to be taking a second look at the Ryzen 3 1200, this time running with a 4GHz overclock versus the G4560. Some of you in the comments from the last video pointed out that my Counter-Strike and Rocket League benchmarks weren't a good reflection of actual online performance, and you were right, they were pretty far off. I revamped the benchmarks to give a much more accurate picture of how those two play online. First up, we'll look at Cinebench. On the multi-core benchmark, it's no surprise that the quad-core Ryzen 3 1200 destroys the dual-core G4560, with the Ryzen 3 scoring 614 and the G4560 eking out a meager 375. Running the single-core benchmark nets much closer results, but with AMD still coming out ahead. 160 for the Ryzen 3 versus 137 for the G4560. That's 17% faster single-core performance and almost 64% faster multi-core for the R3 1200. Now the game results. First on the list is Battlefield 1. At low settings, the Ryzen 3 1200 pretty well crushes the G4560. 172 average FPS versus 133, with both lows around 24% faster for the Ryzen 3. That means at low, the game never dips below 60 FPS with the R3, whereas the G4560 dips down to 50. Medium settings are similar, with the 1200 enjoying a 32 FPS average increase and 10 FPS higher 1% and 0.1% lows. On high, the RX 480 starts bottlenecking with both averages at 94 FPS. The Ryzen 3 does have a 7 frame higher 1% low and 13 FPS higher 0.1% low. Similarly on Ultra, the averages are identical, with the Ryzen 3 keeping lows 4 FPS and 7 FPS higher respectively. With these results, Battlefield 1 is an easy win for the overclocked Ryzen 3 1200. Next, we'll look at Counter-Strike Global Offensive, this time with a much more accurate benchmark for online performance. At the lowest settings, the Ryzen 3 outperforms the G4560 by 70 FPS average. Lows are much closer, though the R3 still comes out on top. 10 FPS higher 1% lows and 6 FPS higher 0.1% lows. On medium settings, the G4560 trails by 69 FPS average, 8 FPS in the 1%, and 4 FPS in the 0.1%. On high, the R3 bumps up the average by 65 FPS with a fairly significant 64% higher 1% low and almost double in the 0.1% low. Counter-Strike Global Offensive is another easy victory for the Ryzen 3, which outperformed the G4560 at every metric. Third in line is Deus Ex Mankind Divided. Even with an RX 480, this game still gets GPU bound very quickly. On low settings, however, there is a sizable difference between the Ryzen 3 1200 and G4560. The R3 runs a 13 FPS higher average, 19 FPS higher 1% low, and a 21% higher 0.1% low. At high and ultra settings, however, there's very little difference between them. Averages are identical, indicating a GPU bottleneck, though the Ryzen 3 does run 4 FPS higher 1% and 0.1% lows at high settings. On ultra, the only difference is a slightly higher 0.1% low going to AMD. Where there are differences in Deus Ex Mankind Divided, the Ryzen 3 comes out ahead. AMD gets the win here. GTA 5 with its quirky performance issues is up next. Give it too much CPU power and the game becomes a stuttering mess, as you'll see on this chart. On low settings, the Ryzen 3 does average 25% faster than the G4560, but frame rates will drop into the teens, making the game a distractingly laggy affair. At medium settings, the issue corrects itself, with the R3 averaging 95 FPS versus the G4560's 74 frames per second. 1% and 0.1% lows also give the edge to the Ryzen 3, with a 6 FPS and 8 FPS increase respectively. On high, the R3 again comes out ahead with 10 FPS higher average, 6 FPS faster 1% low, and 10 FPS faster 0.1% low. Barring the anomalous performance on low settings, the Ryzen 3 1200 runs between 15 and 30% faster than the G4560. In GTA 5, AMD gets the win. Just Cause 3 can have some performance quirks, but in this case, the results are very clear. On low, the Ryzen 3 1200 has a whopping 40 FPS increase over the G4560 on average, 21 FPS higher 1% low, and 18 FPS higher 0.1% low. On medium, the saga continues, with the G4560 trailing by over 40 FPS average, 20 FPS slower 1% lows, and 16 FPS slower in the 0.1% lows. High settings continue the mashing, with the Ryzen 3 averaging 90 FPS, while the G4560 only hits 62 frames per second. 1% and 0.1% lows are also much better for the R3, about 15 FPS better in both cases. In Just Cause 3, the Ryzen 3 1200 hits a 48% faster average on low settings, 57% faster on medium, and 45% faster on high. Lows are between 60 and 90% better with the AMD chip. Just Cause 3 is a huge win for AMD. Overwatch is up next. An important thing to note is that this game is limited to 300 FPS and, as far as I can tell, cannot be unlocked. Across all settings, the averages are nearly identical, with the G4560 never more than 3% faster than the Ryzen 3. Differences between the chips only really show up in the lows. On low settings, the G4560 keeps 1% lows almost 30 FPS higher than the R3 and 0.1% lows 20 FPS higher. The biggest change is on high settings, with the Ryzen CPU trailing by 17 FPS in the 1% lows and more than 50 FPS in the 0.1% lows. On Epic settings, the processors are almost identical, with a roughly 5% performance gain going to the G4560. In an odd reversal of the trend, Overwatch seems to prefer Intel's architecture. Something about the game engine just works better with Team Blue. In Overwatch, Intel gets the win. The booming PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds is up next. Just as a reminder, since this game is still in early access, these benchmarks may not be accurate in the future due to performance patches. For now though, this is how it went down. On very low settings, the G4560 has a slight lead in average frame rate, 110 FPS versus the Ryzen 3's 102. Intel falls far behind in the lows, however. 1% lows are more than 80% lower and 0.1% lows are less than half that of the Ryzen 3's. On medium settings, the trend reverses, with the G4560 leading by 14 FPS average, 5 FPS in the 1% lows, and 5 FPS in the 0.1% lows. On Ultra, the G4560 again leads the average by 12 FPS, but lows are virtually identical. PUBG is a bit of a tough call. From my experience, most people play on very low settings for maximum performance. After all, a few stuttering frames could get you killed. On the other hand, the game is really pretty on high settings. I'm gonna call it a win for AMD due to the much better 1% and 0.1% performance at low settings. That's where the game is played most often and, in my opinion, the most enjoyable. Finally, we have Rocket League. I revised the benchmarks to much more accurately reflect performance while playing online, so from now on these results should very closely mirror what you'll experience with similar hardware. On low settings, the Ryzen 3 1200 leads average FPS by almost 70 frames, 295 versus the G4560's 226. Lows with the 1200, however, are worse than those of the G4560. 1% trails by 11 FPS, and 0.1% trails by a fairly significant 16 frames per second. On medium settings, the Ryzen again leads an average FPS by about 50 frames, but also leads the 1% lows by about 25 frames. 0.1% lows are again lower than those of the G4560, with Intel maintaining 127 FPS and AMD dropping to 113. On high settings, the results are virtually identical, 166 average and about 118 in the 1% lows, but the Ryzen does lead in 0.1% lows by 10% over the G4560. The thing to note is that this is another one of those weird situations where the game runs worse on lower settings. Real-world best performance is achieved on medium render and detail settings. For that reason, the Ryzen 3 1200 comes out ahead here. Next, we'll look at power consumption and temperatures. Both CPUs are running on stock cooling, and these power draws are measured from the wall. At idle, the Ryzen 3 1200 hovers around 44 degrees Celsius, and the computer draws about 87 watts. The G4560 runs a bit cooler at 40 degrees Celsius and uses slightly less power at 78 watts. While playing CSGO, the Ryzen 3 heats up to 63 degrees Celsius, while the G4560 stabilizes at around 58. The Ryzen 3 also uses significantly more power, 235 watts versus the G4560's 173. Finally, while stress testing with Prime 95 and Unigine's Valley, the Ryzen 3 tops out at 74 degrees Celsius, while the G4560 only hits 61. The difference in power consumption is much closer, with the AMD system drawing 260 watts from the wall and the Intel system only drawing 224. In terms of total power use, there's no question that Intel's G4560 is the winner. However, for all but a very small handful of people, power usage isn't even a consideration. In addition to that, performance per watt is much closer because the Ryzen 3 also runs faster than the G4560. More power, more performance. Makes sense to me. Oh, and just to be clear, the Ryzen 3 1200 was overclocked on stock cooling. No fancy aftermarket heatsinks, no AIO coolers, just the Wraith stealth that AMD gives you with the processor. If you want to see my guide for overclocking Ryzen 3 and Ryzen 5 and 7 processors, click the link in the description or the card in the top right of this video. In summary, the overclocked Ryzen 3 1200 absolutely mashes the G4560. Even in Overwatch, where Intel does come out ahead, the Ryzen 3 is only behind by about 10%. When you introduce overclocking to the equation, AMD just outright destroys Intel in performance per dollar. The G4560 can't be overclocked at all. AMD's cheapest offering, the 1200, can. The least expensive processor from Intel that can be overclocked is the i3-7350K, a chip that costs almost $40 more than the Ryzen 3 1200. In addition to that, to overclock an Intel processor, you need a Z series motherboard. Those start out another $45 or $50 above the price of overclockable AMD motherboards. After running these tests, and because Intel increased the price of the G4560 to within spitting distance of the 1200, I can say wholeheartedly that AMD once again owns the budget arena, hands down. I'll be making a comparison video between the Ryzen 3 1200 and Intel's i5-7500 next. It'll be interesting to see how an AMD quad core stacks up to an Intel quad core that costs almost $100 more. If you want to get notified of that as soon as it's up, hit subscribe and then click the bell icon to enable notifications. If you want to pick up any of the parts I used, links are in the description below. So guys, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit subscribe. And if you have any questions on the Ryzen 3 1200, the G4560, or these benchmarks, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, I hope I helped, and I'll see you in the next video.